Good morning. Welcome once again to Sunday School with New Life Church of Orlando. We're located 3311 North Powers Drive in Orlando, Florida. Bishop Derek W. Hutchins is our pastor. Our studies are coming from the Christian Life series, Union Gospel Press. I'm Ruthie Warren. Today is Sunday, May 16, 2021. What an awesome lesson we have today. Saved by faith. Our scriptural text, Romans the 10th chapter, verses 1 through 10. We have three outlines today. Praying for the lost, pursuing righteousness, and professing faith in Christ. On last week, we talked about a sovereign God who has the authority to elect whom he will. He has the authority to have mercy on whom he will have mercy, and compassion on whom he would have compassion. On last week, Paul was a little disturbed at Israel's position, being that they were the chosen people, yet they rejected the Messiah. So today we're going to talk about saved by faith. Israel wanted to have it their way and use their intellect to set the standards for salvation. So let's see what our lesson is going to talk about today. Number one, the golden text. You've heard it before. Romans 10 and 9. If thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thine heart that God has raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. So that's in our text on today. But might I say this? Sadly, we live in a time when many people don't believe that they are lost. They fail to realize that they are in need of salvation. They assume that if there is a heaven, they will certainly be included to go there. After all, not saying they're righteous, but what wrong do they do? And if you approach them, they will many times say, "I'm all right, I'm good." That's today's vernacular, "I'm good." So, believing that they are already in good condition with God, they fail to realize that they too are in need of salvation. Salvation will do one thing. Salvation will assure your everlasting life. Without it, you are hell bound. So let's look at our lesson today. Outline number one, praying for the lost. Romans 10, verse 1. Paul is saying, "Brethren, my heart's desire and prayer to God for Israel is that they might be saved." I tell you, Paul was very concerned. Last week, he offered to give his own life if Israel would just acknowledge the Messiah. Verse number 2. "For I bear them record that they have a zeal of God, but not according to knowledge." So Israel knows about God, and they are excited and enthusiastic, but not with the right scope of knowledge. Again, they're using their intellect to bring perspective into the matter. Let's read outline number 2, pursuing righteousness. For they being ignorant of God's righteousness, this is Israel, and going about to establish their own righteousness, have not submitted themselves unto the righteousness of God. God's righteousness is Jesus is the Messiah. Israel yet is rejecting them. Verse number 4, "For Christ is the end of the law for righteousness to everyone that believeth. The law will not save you." If mankind could adhere to the total law, then yes, they could be saved. But there was only one who could adhere to the total law, and that was Jesus Christ. For Christ is the end of the law for righteousness to everyone that believeth. For Moses described the righteousness which is of the law, that the man which does those things shall live by them. If you believe it that strongly, believe every word of it. But the righteousness which is of faith speaketh on this wise. Say not in thine heart, who shall ascend into heaven? That is to bring Christ down from above. Or who shall descend into the deep? That is to bring Christ up again from the dead. Well, Christ has come down before, and he has been resurrected. So there is no need for him to go through that eventful exercise again. Therefore, we believe in Christ. He has already had the victory over those things. But what saith it, verse number 8? The word is nigh thee, even in thy mouth and in thy heart. That is the word of faith which we preach. Now, saints, we are disciples. We are as Paul. We are trying to recruit, trying to help our unsaved loved ones come to Christ. The last outline, professing faith in Christ. We've got to be strong disciples and bold, just as Paul is or was. Professing faith in Christ. Let's see. Verse number 9, this is one that we have learned. We know it well. And as disciples, we really have to be bold enough to submit it to an unsaved loved one. And it reads, that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thine heart that God has raised him from the dead, Jesus, thou shalt be saved. And that's the message we would want to impart unto our unsaved loved ones. For with the heart, man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth, confession is made unto salvation. Saints, that's the only way. Jesus is the answer, the way, the truth, and the life. And the only way to everlasting life is to confess and to believe. Let's go on. Ephesians chapter 2, verses 8 through 9. For by grace are we saved through faith. We've got to believe. And that not of ourselves. It is the gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast. And so, this is the way to salvation. And that's what Paul is saying. The good confession. Remember, if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, that's the good confession. The good confession is a confession of hope, not the same as confessing our sins, a different kind of confessing. Another confession, Peter's great confession. What was it? Thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God, Matthew 16:1. The truth upon which Christ would build his church. Not only must we believe in our hearts that Christ died for our sin and arose the third day, but we must be willing to acknowledge this openly. This is critical. Paul said, for I'm not ashamed of the gospel. We've got to be willing to acknowledge God openly. Confess with our mouth and believe in our heart, and thou shalt be saved, according to scripture. Now, let's go ahead and conclude this lesson. Saved by faith. Fact, to study the biblical teaching of salvation by faith is simply by believing. And I use the word simply. We must believe. The principle, to understand that we are saved by faith and not by any human effort. The Pharisees were good at trying to set a standard. Application, to share with others the good news of salvation by faith in Jesus Christ. We are disciples of Christ. Listen, ask yourself the question, can praying for the unsaved help? I'm so glad that you asked. Yes. Number one, prayer can soften the hearts of the unsaved. Number two, prayer may cause the unsaved to realize their lost condition. Number three, prayer will empower believers, that's us saints, to speak God's word with boldness, just like Paul, and enable a clear, powerful witness to be presented to the lost. They may not receive it at first, but it may marinate and they may come to a decision. Having correct knowledge is very important. We've got to believe. Hosea 4 and 6, my people are destroyed for the lack of knowledge. Because thou hast rejected knowledge, I will reject thee, saith the Lord. Righteousness, listen, is only received, only gifted through faith. You can only get it through faith. Faith in Christ alone. If man would actually prefer the law, to obey the law, then he must live by the law, and his righteousness is of the law. But only Jesus, again, only Jesus could make the claim to righteousness by the law. We are righteous. We've given a privilege to be righteous by faith. We don't have to live to all those multiple standards that are in the law. Can a person believe in Christ and still be unwilling to confess him? Can they? Listen, not only must we believe in our hearts that Christ died for our sins and arose the third day, we must be willing to acknowledge this openly. We've got to openly confess. This is critical. Matthew 10:32-33, whosoever therefore shall confess me before men, him will I confess also before my Father, which is in heaven. But whosoever shall deny me, Jesus, before men, him will I also deny before my Father, which is in heaven. We need to confess, believe, and acknowledge. The heart represents the inner person where their faith exists. The mouth must express what's in the heart. The heart expresses, but the mouth expresses what's in the heart. Such faith leads to righteousness. And righteousness is simply a right relationship with God. Confessing Christ, confessing Jesus, leads to salvation. We must believe and confess. It's just that simple. After confessing Christ, we must progress in holiness, or else we will remain in a baby state. As the scripture says, we'll be babes in Christ. Holiness will enable us to grow up. Listen, listen, listen. Grace, salvation is free, but it's not cheap. Did you hear me? Grace and salvation is free, but it's not cheap. Martyred German pastor Dietrich Bonhoeffer wrote, listen to what he wrote. He said, cheap grace is preaching of forgiveness without requiring repentance. Cheap grace is baptism without church disputes or church discipline. Cheap grace is communion without confession. Cheap grace is absolution without personal confession. Grace without discipleship. Grace without the cross. Grace without Jesus Christ. Such grace is really no grace at all. That's cheap grace. No grace at all. Saving grace belief in Jesus is costly, not to us, but it was costly to Jesus. He gave up his life. He overcame both death and hell for us who would believe in him. I stress. Believe. We confess that Jesus is Lord. By faith in his perfect righteousness, we have full righteousness and are adopted as God's sons and daughter. Who would not want to be the son of God? Who would not want to be one of his daughters? God bless you. I'll see you next week, and let's talk more about gaining salvation. God bless you.